So I am excited. This is our first official interview here at CBB. I'm sitting here with Katrina Butts, who she is one of our very hardworking members who's been very successful. She was successful before she came to Custom Body Boot Camp. She lost 100 pounds before she came, and she's lost around 60 pounds since she's been here. And if you're here at the 5 a.m. class, you will see her in here working extremely hard, sometimes 5, a lot of times 5:30 as well. And then sometimes they've been getting out in the evening and doing a third workout. She's a great example of being committed and then what can happen when you actually do commit and you put yourself out there to create some change in your life. I'm super proud of you here, and I know it feels great to be where you're at.
Absolutely.
First, I'm just going to kind of let you tell your story a little bit. Kind of tell about what triggered you to kind of start changing and where it all began.
Sure. So a couple of years back, we always have that bad picture that someone takes of you and you just don't like it whatsoever. Once I saw that picture, I knew that there was a problem. My weight had gone up to over 350 pounds and I didn't recognize it over the years. I was really invested into being a mom and my kids and not really putting the focus on myself. But when I saw that picture, I realized that I needed to get healthy for not only my own health, but for my kids so that I could be around as long as possible for them. Without our health, we have nothing. And life is so fragile. I know that we have lost a lot of loved ones over the years to different things that weren't controllable and a lot of things that were controllable. I had issues like high blood pressure. I had asthma and bronchitis and anxiety. Just overall from the stress that I was putting on my body from being so severely overweight. I decided at the beginning of the year of 2015 to make a change. January 2nd, I actually started my journey. Starting with the simplest things, just moving more, not sitting around all day, and definitely changing my diet for the better.
And this is one of the things here at Custom Body Bootcamp. I'm having conversations often, and I have people kind of in your situation as I'm sitting down, and I kind of try to explain that to them. But it's so powerful hearing it kind of coming from you. And I mean, it is a big change, and it's an emotional part. Can you explain it? Is there emotional parts to this?
There's absolutely an emotional part to it. You know, I say that weight loss is very mental. Some days I wake up and I don't feel that I've made as much progress as I should, but sometimes I look in the mirror and I don't see any change because my mind hasn't quite caught up with who I am today from who I was before. I think that the connection with yourself is what drives me to push myself to work out every day, to make healthy food option choices for myself, to stay motivated and to have incentive to carry along this journey as long as I have, and to work as hard as I do, and to stay committed and to stay focused on this journey.
Yeah, wow. And that's one of the things I remember with you too, because like she was in here working out. She lost 14 pounds on her first 28-day challenge when you started here. And I remember I think you're down 30, 40 pounds at that point, and I kept saying you look great, and you're like, I don't see it. And I'm sitting there like, what, are you kidding me? So, and it was funny because if you remember, like when we took that first before picture, it was like you came back like, oh well, okay, I see it now. But it is interesting how we do judge ourselves and we see ourselves as when we look in the mirror, because it's like that's happened often here at the boot camp and just our image of the way that we see ourselves. So, let's kind of get into the nitty gritty. So, I mean, if you see her working now, she's one of our super women here for sure. So it's like losing 160 pounds, starting from 350. She's in here just working and grinding. And you can see, like, as she's working out sometimes, like, you can see the stress and everything that you're going through. So, like, as you're going through the workouts, well, actually, let's first start, because I want people who are listening who may be in your situation, like, have 100 or pound, more pounds to lose, kind of give them the process of what it took for you to start to take, like, each day taking a step forward to keep start being successful.
Sure. So a lot of my friends that are on my Facebook page, they know that I post every day about my workout. From day one, I've always to the gym to hold myself accountable, not because I'm just the crazy girl that likes to talk about her workout every day, but because I had to build in a system that worked for me for accountability. I'm making sure that I'm telling everyone that I'm on this journey that wants to listen, because if you're doing it in silence, you don't really have that motivation and that support system to keep you focused. And I think that was the biggest thing for me, is to just have people that were in my corner that wanted to see me do better, because you always have that friend that says, hey, let's go out and eat, and you try to choose a healthy option and they say, well, why are you eating that? And you say, oh, well, I can cheat today. Well, the system that I built for myself is that there's no leniency. I have a goal that I want to get to and things to accomplish, so I don't get distracted by shiny things like cake, like fried chicken, because I know that that's not going to help me along this journey. And making sure that I'm working hard as possible every workout that I put in, because I don't want to ruin the workout that I just put in for food at the end of the day. I've always made sure that I'm prepared in advance for the week, so making sure that I'm meal prepped so that I don't have to make a choice to go through a drive-through and maybe eat even a salad that may not be as healthy as we think that it is, because salads sometimes are set. But I make sure that my meal plan is prepared for the week and that I'm ready to go. I make sure that I'm ready for my workout every day in advance, so that I don't wake up and say, I'll skip this one today, because skipping it is just not an option. Those are the biggest things that keep me focused. That's the way that I prepare, is making sure that my meal plans are ready, that my workout routine for the week is set, whether it's scheduling my boot camp classes for every week, 2 weeks in advance. I do other workouts outside of the gym. 2 to 3 times a week, I try to do something different. I incorporate other workout routines. Every month, I try something new. A couple of months back, I incorporated adding a second boot camp class, so I do 5 and 5:30. More recently, I've been doing 3 classes. Friday last week, I did 5, 5:30, and 6 o'clock, but I did 5, 5:30, and 9 o'clock for a couple of weeks. But, you know, I could add in other workouts, or even something as simple as increasing the weight that we're lifting. If I was lifting 10 last week, I'm going to go to 12. If I'm at 12, I'll go to 15. Just trying to do more and push myself to not stay the same, because our body really needs to have change. You can't let your body get comfortable with your workout routine. You know, some people walk on their lunch break, and maybe in the beginning it was a good thing, and you started losing weight and you started seeing a change in yourself, but eventually your body kind of just doesn't make any additional changes. So I've made sure to switch up my routine every month and incorporate something different, from yoga to maybe running. We have the movement runners here in our boot camp, and I see a lot of girls, they have their own little running groups, and they've incorporated that into their workout routine. People that couldn't have ordinarily seen themselves as runners now embrace it and enjoy it and have bonded behind it, and you know, go to the gym, walk in the afternoon, make sure that you're doing something more than what you were doing before, and just don't get comfortable in your routine.
That's amazing as she brings that up. Like, one of the things that is I'm always trying to help and teach people as far as making the correct choices and making, like, moving forward, is like it's been a process for you to get to where you're at, to be able to handle 2-3 classes and work out 2-3 times a day. And a lot of times people anticipate through seeing like shows like The Biggest Loser and all these ridiculous shows that are out there showing these transformations where it's like you lose 50 pounds in a week. I mean, you know, being a little big as there, but but that's the thing. It's like, it's been a process. Like, you haven't got to this point. And that's for anybody watching. It's like, you're not going to just come in and be able to do 3 classes, and you're not going to do yourself any good, because you're probably going to hurt yourself. It takes time to develop the fitness, because that's what it is. You're developing fitness. You're developing strength, and that's what you're working towards. And it's amazing. I mean, seeing her work out sometimes, because I'm like, ooh, she's just a machine, and she just goes and goes and goes. So it's awesome, and congrats to that. So it's a great accomplishment. So.
Well, it was definitely a build-up, and like Chris said, it's not an overnight thing. you know, some of the girls have seen that we, there's a few of us, we've added in leg weights. You know, something just simple, not necessarily having to work out as much as I do, or lifting as heavy as I do, but just doing a little bit more, to increase what you were doing before.
Yeah, that's great. So, let's ask, so during the workouts, because a lot of times, like when you're doing the boot camp workouts here, I mean, they can be pretty intense, and that's, like sometimes, like I actually worked out last night, and my wife just had a baby, so it was like, I'm not in the best shape that I've ever been right now, so I'm kind of starting to get back into it myself. But I know last night on the last run, I was actually starting to feel a little dizzy because I might have been pushing a little bit over my limit there. But what do you do like when you start getting into that mental part to where it's like you want to quit, but you...
You know, sometimes it's something strange happens. When I'm at my lowest point and I just want to give up, something in my brain kind of kicks in and says, if it hurts this bad, something good is happening. When you're feeling those muscles starting to burn, not necessarily hurt and pain, well, sometimes it might be painful, but when you're feeling that burn, I know that a new muscle is being created, so I have to push on to get the results that I'm looking for. You know, I might wake up and not want to roll out of bed, but my motivation is making sure that I know what I want for myself, so that means that I have to get in here to do this workout, that I have to push through the pain at the end of the workout, that I have to stay focused for myself. Otherwise, I won't get the results that I'm looking for. So I do push through that pain. And, you know, if you have to stop for a second or two, you stop for a second or two, but you just have to pick yourself up and keep going.
Yes, great advice. So, like, when you're setting your goals, how do you go about set? Because that's one of the things, like, goal setting and knowing where you want to get to is important. So what would you recommend to people as far as setting goals?
So I think that there's a few different ways to set your goals. I set a long-term goal, so where I want to be eventually. And then I set a bunch of short-term goals along the way. Right now, I'm not in the habit of weighing in because my focus right now isn't so much on weight because I've lost so much. I'm working on more toning. But making sure that you set those small goals. So maybe your goal is to lose 10 pounds by the end of the month, or maybe your goal is to take a second boot camp class, or maybe your goal is to walk 30 minutes on my lunch break. Maybe my goal is to cut out your latte. Maybe your goal is to increase the weight that you're using. But making sure that you're setting yourself up for goals to accomplish and not letting yourself down. My long-term goal ultimately is to get to a certain weight. But, you know, I travel a lot. A lot of the girls know that I travel a lot. So maybe my goal is to fit into a swimsuit. Or maybe I'll buy a pair of jeans that are a couple of sizes smaller and put them on every week until I get there. Because then I know I've accomplished the goal that I set for myself, but making sure that you're setting yourself up for success. So some people might walk in here and feel like, well, I want to lose 50 pounds by next month. Well, obviously it's not a realistic goal. So you have to just start slowly so that you don't get discouraged because you're not hitting those goals. And just make sure that even if you say, I want to lose 10 pounds by the end of the month and you don't lose those 10 pounds, continue to push on for that goal and don't just let it go by the wayside, but making sure that you accomplish that mission and get that goal taken care of, crossed off your list, and move on to the next one.
Yes. And give yourself a pat on the back.
Pat on the back when it's
like
done.
Like, even you're going to do that too?
Oh, yeah.
And that's the thing, like, I mean, isn't this information great that she's providing? Because, like, the goals are important in setting the long-term goal and the little short-term goals, because you have to be working to where you want to get to, and you have to have attainable goals. And it never goes, like, if you're up here and you want to get down to this certain weight, it's not going to go straight in a straight arrow. There's going to be like a stock market, up and down. There's going to be, you got to go through the mental, you got to go through the physical. There's a lot of change that's happening. I had somebody recently tell me, evolving, and that's, it is, it's kind of, you are evolving, you're changing your, the person who you are, the being. Actually, do you want to kind of, like, what has been your transformation? Like, would you say, like, from where you started to where you're at now?
Well, I know that for myself, it was kind of an awakening. awakening once I lost this large amount of weight. I think that I started to come out of my shell where I wasn't so afraid to be around people and to speak to people because I wasn't as self-conscious. And I started to go out socially more and have more friends and not be afraid to be in front of the camera. And, you know, I take pictures all the time because that's part of what I do, because that's how I hold myself accountable. Because if I like what I see, then I continue to work towards looking even better. If I don't like what I see, then I know that I have to work harder, change something up, and work harder. But I had to relearn who I was as a person, as the new person, because I did change, and my attitude changed, and my personality changed, and my outlook on life changed. And so it is an evolution, losing this much weight coming from where I went to where I am now. I did have to relearn who I am and, you know, make sure that it was a positive change, but I did have to relearn myself.
And that's this is my favorite part of training. And I know earlier Ingrid, one of our trainers here, she was telling me recently about how it's her favorite part too. It's this transformation you see in people. And it doesn't matter who you are or even where you're at. As you start to exercise, take care of yourself, and put good, healthy foods in your body, you start to feel better about who you are. And it's a natural thing that kind of progresses as you start to take the action to start doing it. Doesn't mean it's always easy. I mean, the thing is, it's like we got to deal with our minds. We got to deal with all the old habits, and we got to deal with all these patterns. And you just kind of keep moving forward and taking the actions. And I mean, it's I tell people this all the time. I'm like, what if I can have somebody who's lived through it? And it's like, yes, this is great info. So it's like, you guys live, and like all the things she's talking about now, it's like, you just have to understand this is a process. It's like, you're not going to be able to do all the things at once. It's like every single day is a new day. You just keep taking a step forward. And even if you take a step back or two steps back, then you'll take 10 more steps forward later. But you'll learn from those when you're, there is no failing. Like failing just does not exist. So if you want to be successful, you have to learn from your lessons.
Yes, absolutely. It hasn't been a straight shot. It hasn't been always a week where I lost weight or that I accomplished my goals. There's been some times where my weight has gone up and down. People that work out with me know that I start training on the opposite side than we're on right now, in front of the mirror. And I start in front of the mirror because if I like what I see, then it motivates me to do well on my workout. If I don't like what I see, then it lets me know that I need to refocus what I'm doing. And there are some times where I might have gone up a little bit. Maybe my stomach is bigger than it should be because I maybe drank too much or something that month. Because alcohol is terrible. Don't drink. it's not good for the diet. Believe me. But, you know, you have to keep it all in perspective. And know that you're not going to be perfect, and I'm not perfect, and it hasn't been the easiest journey. You know, being a couple of years into my journey already, it didn't happen overnight. I didn't learn what I know now overnight. It didn't happen from doing just one thing. I've done lots of things. I've worked with lots of people. But the time that I've invested with Custom Body Bootcamp now, over a year and a few months now, I've seen the most success here. From having the support of everyone in our community, as well as having great trainers, very inspirational, that keep you focused, meal plans that are available to us. We can talk anytime with our trainers, and you have outside groups like the running groups that are associated with boot camp. But they continue to push us to work harder, and that's why I've spent so much of my weight loss journey here at Custom Body Bootcamp. This is where I've seen the best success.
Yes, thank you for that too. But what advice, let's say somebody is, and we have people who are always scared because of the boot camp.
The boot camp.
This isn't military boot camp.
Not at all.
I mean, if I'm training, I'm out there talking a lot of smack, but that's just what I do. But what would you tell somebody who's a little nervous and just afraid to take that first step?
Well, I've had a lot of friends that have started working out here, and they were initially afraid. One of the things that got me into the third workout was a friend that was afraid of boot camp, because the thought of boot camp is someone screaming in your face like a sergeant, pointing down on you, making you do it. That's not what we have here. Our trainers are tough, and they're going to make sure that you're pushed to be successful, but it's not that kind of boot camp. We're working hard here for sure. It's more family holding you accountable, but the first step is deciding what you want. So again, back to that goal, what you want. If you want to lose weight, if you want to commit to yourself, if you want to get healthy, because it's not always about weight. It is certainly more of a health commitment to ourselves. But you have to know what you want out of it. It's not going to be an overnight thing. It's not going to happen. You might come for a 14 or a 28-day trial or a challenge, but it's going to be a lifelong commitment. So if you're willing to commit to yourself, then you're going to be okay here, because this is something that you will learn to function for a lifetime, because we're learning how to eat right, how to make healthy choices, how to work out properly. So it's not just, you know, us just lifting weights at the gym next to some muscle-bound guy and we really don't know what we're doing. We're here learning proper techniques. We're learning exercises that we can do at home. When you're traveling, it doesn't require you to walk into a gym with what we do here, because we do things that you can do without being inside of a workout structure. So I definitely think that you have to make the commitment to yourself and know what you want in order to walk into any place to get help on this fitness journey.
Yes, and the key is getting active. So it's just being active, being healthy, eating good, healthy food, trying to stay away from processed foods, lots of good fruit and vegetables, healthy proteins, that sort of thing. So we'll kind of finish up here. We'll finish up with, where do you go from here? Like, what's your vision of your future self, and then how do you visualize and what do you want to create from this point forward?
Well, the funny thing is, along the journey, people always said you should become a personal trainer, or you're so inspirational, you should be a motivational speaker. You know, I think at this point, I love what I've accomplished, and being that I talk to people all the time about my journey, I definitely want to continue to be on the path of being an accountability coach, to someday become a personal trainer, just so that I can help people that were once in my situation in the future. I help people every day, all the time. People come up to me, seeing my post, or maybe they have seen me change at boot camp. And so I love to share the insight that I have and just give tidbits. I had a young lady tell me, you know, oh, I just did so terrible yesterday. I ate like Fruity Pebbles for dinner. And, you know, my best advice was get it out of your house, because you know, if you don't have that type of setup around you, then you'll make better choices. If you just have to have that cereal, let's replace it with a more nutritious cereal. Let's do almond milk over that whole milk you're drinking. But, you know, I love to help people. So I definitely see myself staying on this fitness path, and it'll help me to remain fit and healthy forever.
Yeah, we're not going to let her slide, so we'll go drag her out of her house if we have to. So, but anyway, so this is great. So we loved having you in. This is my first interview, so hopefully this went well. So it was fun.
Yeah.
But yeah, thank you for being here. So I hope everybody enjoyed this. If you have any questions, let us know. So Katrina Butts, I had a people here. Give me a hand. You want to show people your guns here? Look at the guns. So, you know, show. We got to show those things off. So, but it's the hard work. So it's like she's in here. She's putting in the effort. It's awesome. She's working, feeling good. She is inspiring a lot of our members here and other people as well. And that's kind of what it's all about. It's about getting out and helping other people through. And that takes you focusing. It's the self-love. You got to focus on yourself. If you want to be able to give and help everybody else, you'll be able to give way more if you're focusing on yourself. And you're doing what's right for you, because when that will translate into everything else. And that's one of the things of being healthy, exercising, eating good food, and just being active. It doesn't have, like, even if it's not boot camp, yeah, I want you in here, but even if you're not here, just get out and move, be healthy, learn to eat healthy, be patient with it. So, but I can talk about this stuff forever, and I always ramble on some of this stuff. But thank you much. Appreciate having you on.
Anytime.
So
make sure you guys commit to yourself. You guys can all do it. Everyone can do it. Everyone starts at a different point. You don't have to be heavy. You don't have to be young. You don't have to be old. You can be anybody and start this journey at any time. We have every different type of man, woman in our boot camp, from young to old, from fit to skinny, from every nationality. It's just about making the commitment to yourself for your life, because this is a lifelong goal. It's not just a short term.
Love it. All right, well, thank you. And if you guys have any questions, you can message us here on the post. I'm sure you can probably even ask Katrina questions on there too. And
yes.
If you guys have any questions about Custom Body Bootcamp, give us a call, 424-393-4055, or you can email us at info@custombodybootcamp.com. So hope everybody has a great day, and we'll see you soon.